Hi guys, today I'm going to be doing a review of a fantastic rum. It's Diplomatico Ambassador selection, and it's from Venezuela, and it's distilled by Distillerías Unidas SA, which are very well known distillers in Venezuela that produce some of the top branded rums that go about, especially in Latin American type rums. Fantastic distillery. It's produced by Diplomatico range of rums, and for any of you who know Diplomatico range of rums, you'll know that Diplomatico Exclusiva, I've done a review of that one, absolutely fantastic rum. Ambassador essentially is the finest stocks of Exclusiva, which is aged for 12 years in oak casks. And then they take the finest stocks. Not every barrel, you know, comes up to standard. It's only the finest. And then they transfer them into Pedro Jimenez sherry casks. And for a further 2 years of aging. And the outcome is just absolutely amazing. Rich, intense and complex rum, which we'll talk about later. If you have a look at the actual display here, on the front here, you've got a medallion encased into the centre of the case there, and that's of Juancho Nieto Melendez. Now, this guy was from the house of Botucal, Hacienda Botucal, and he had a passion for travelling the world and discovering new techniques and in going into depth with learning new techniques of all local indigenous drinks and spirits. And rum was one of his passions. And he was particularly was really interested and fascinated by how rum, you can say you were to turn around and follow a strict recipe on making, say, 5 barrels of rum or 100 barrels of rum, and you done everything at the same time and you put them all into the same oak casks, and then you age them for your set number of years. When it came to sampling them and tasting, that there could be quite a vast change in different tastes. You know, certain rum, it's not necessarily going to get a very same taste throughout the whole range. It can vary quite a lot, and it fascinated him. And basically, another area that fascinated him was where terroir comes into play, where the elements and the humidity and, you know, just all the different natural elements come into the taste and end product of a drink as well. So he was a very interesting guy, and he amassed such a massive collection of rums and spirits from around the world, and especially from Jamaica is where he'd done a lot of his research, because at that time Jamaica was the hub and the standard for quality rum. At his time, Jamaica was the place for rum, so he spent a lot of time researching there, and the Antilles, and various other places as well. And like I said, you know, he turned round and he amassed a big collection. And amongst his friends and associates, he was very generous. He used to quite happily let people try his collection, and it became known as the Ambassador's Reserves. So there's a guy here who's obviously loved his drink and real maestro quality bloke. So now we're going to go into more modern day, have a little bit of the history. The guy now in charge of the master blender at Diplomatico is Tito Cordero, and this is where I feel the skill of a master blender comes in, is when you take a rum which is potentially 14 years of age, and it can have, I'm not being funny, but you know, I've tasted rums a lot older than that, a lot more matured, and some of them haven't got a patch on the rum that's 14 years of age. Now, you know, the skill of his blending comes to light when you taste this rum. It is intense. It's been done in a copper pot still, so it's going to be a more richer, more intensely flavoured rum. If I turn around and open it up and show you, absolutely beautifully presented. You're not going to get a rum much. This is a class act on how to produce, how to present a rum. Saying that, you are paying top dollar for it. You're paying a good price for it. So you expect it to be all the bells and knobs on top. You're looking inside, you've got information completely telling you all about the production and tasting notes and what, and about the rum, which is a nice touch. You expect it. It's presented in a lovely wooden box, silt lined. I'll now do away with that and just show you the bottle itself. You then come onto the bottle and do a nice close up. You've got obviously Ambassador Selection. There's another gold embossed medallion on the front of the bottle setting of Juancho Melendez. And it says there Diplomatico Ambassador Selections. Okay, now it's bottled at 47%. 47% alcohol by volume, so a lot more alcoholic there than you would standard 40. Just looks great, doesn't it? As you can see, I have had a little bit out of it. I keep meaning to only have a little one, but when you try them, what's the point of having a rum like this and just keeping it in your box and not drinking it? You know, to me, I'm a firm believer that if you're going to have rum, you want to turn around and make sure that it's for drinking and not just for putting away and looking at. Okay, so now I'm going to pour a little glass. Radio. I'll leave that there so it's just on display. First of all, the first impressions, when you take that bottle out of its box or you open up the box, the first thing that hits you is the intensity of the colour. It's a absolutely deep bronze hue to it. You can see it's a rich, really dark, you know, lovely. You know it's going to have a lot of flavour to it. When you have a look in the glass and you give it a little swirl, don't know if you can see that, but hang on, there we go. Let's have a look. You've got little short legs because it's so pungent. The smell of it is just really itch you. It fills the senses. It really is. It's gorgeous. It's beautiful. And it hits you straight away. And the first thing that I think from this when you smell it is roasted bananas. Vanilla you can smell. Coffee. It's just spiciness. It's just so rich. It's gorgeous. Now we'll take a little taste. Oh, it is so, it's oiliness about it. Say this about rums. I find it a lot with the more intense copper pot still rums. You tend to get an oiliness about them. It disperses around your mouth and tongue and cheeks. It really does help with sending that flavour around. It just overwhelms. It's beautiful. There's an oiliness to it for a start, like I just said. Then you got, you can smell dark chocolate for sure. Coffee. Molasses. There's a molasses flavour in there. There's a slightest tinge of pepper for sure. Vanilla, definitely a tinge of vanilla in there as well. It's just an absolute fruits. It smells, like I said earlier on, roasted banana. Candied fruits. It's just really beautiful rum. It's great. I love it. It's a real treat. It's not one for... I'm sorry, I'm a firm believer of spreading the word. And I do. I'm probably one of the most generous people to give... If I get somebody come round and they show an interest in rum, the cupboard's open and I'm pouring glasses of rum for them to try. I'm quite a generous person in that respect. But this is for yourself, for special occasions, and very selected friends and family. You know, it's a real treat. And I'm afraid that, you know, this one is going to be put in a cupboard and only got out for special occasions when I fancy one. Price of it ain't cheap. You know, you're looking at £195 a bottle to £200 a bottle in the UK. I went to the Rum Fest in October and had this rum. Instead of buying three or four mid-range price rums to bring home, I bought one really nice one as a treat. And, you know, it really is good. Fantastic rum. Get it if you can get it. I'm sure you won't be disappointed. Going back to the Rum Fest this year, great Rum Fest. I feel maybe not as good as the year before. I think what they've done is they put the boutique Rum Fest inside the actual Rum Fest. So a lot of the faces that I had seen the last 4 or 5 years were in the boutique trade-only section. And they went outside on the stalls, what they would normally would be if they were doing it on the Saturday and Sunday. So I think I've heard a lot of comments about I've seen online about that they feel that the Rum Fest this year wasn't as good as the one before, and I think that is, from what I experienced, probably true. So guys, you know, let's turn around and get back to the old method of Boutique Rum Fest being on a separate day, and let's turn around and let the people that represent their rums be out on the stores representing their rums for the ordinary guy on the street that is buying it. So, okay, I'd just like to say that. Other than that, get on, buy yourself a bottle, and enjoy. My name's Andy. Cheers.